Good evening. My name is Ralph Morales, and I am the Director of Instrumental Music for Toloso Midway ISD. I also serve as the Head Band Director at Toloso Midway High School.
My name is Oscar Lara, and I serve as the Director of Choral Activities for Toloso Midway ISD. I also serve as Choir Director for Toloso Midway High School. We welcome everyone to the 2021 Toloso Midway High School graduation ceremony. Unfortunately, we were not able to be here live to perform and celebrate this wonderful achievement with our graduates. This has brought upon a wonderful opportunity for our music programs to collaborate for today's recorded performances.
Please enjoy the performances by our award-winning Toloso Midway High School Choir, Mariachi Tierra Mia, our jazz band, and the Mighty Warrior Band. We congratulate the graduates of the class of 2021 and their families on this magnificent milestone. Thank you.
You may be seated. Good evening, everyone. We are gathered here today to celebrate the commencement of Toloso Midway's graduating class of 2021. I would like to start this off by acknowledging all those in attendance, whether that is watching it here at this facility, from at home through the live stream, or from up above. Thank you for being here with us today, whether that is physically or with us in spirit. Dear graduates, it all started when we were 15, sitting in class as mere freshmen with a hopeful, wide-eyed gaze, as we did not know where high school was going to take us. All we knew was we had time. Suddenly, we were bombarded with Hurricane Harvey. Yet fearlessly as a community, we picked up the pieces and strived forward as the year progressed. Even then, the light at the end of the tunnel appeared. For the first time in nearly a decade, back to December, we jumped then fell into the snow as we were able to live as kids again, making snowmen and snow angels and having snowball fights for a day. Soon enough, our first year of high school was completed as the spring semester rolled around where we were thinking it was the best day, or week for that matter, since semester exams were canceled because of TM's power outage. School was over. We were no longer fresh meat or the little fish in a huge ocean. We could finally breathe. Still innocent and delicate, being considered underclassmen as sophomores, we took on the year just as we had done before, only more confident as we roamed the halls. We were no longer on the outside, at least not metaphorically, but literally we were, thanks to the countless times TM's AC went out that year, which meant more days off in our eyes. In the following semester, never did we think we'd have to grieve the loss of one of our own. Yet once again, as a community, we stayed together supporting one another at a time when we needed it most. It acted as a reminder to us all to be careful and to be there for each other and our loved ones. For time is a precious gift and tomorrow is never promised. Therefore, it instilled that we must cherish the moments we have while we still have them. With the end of sophomore year came junior year. We were officially upperclassmen who also quickly became college students with an extensive course load. Little did we know, they were not kidding when they said junior year would be the most horrendous. Speak now, we thought, as everyone yelled and cheered during Friday night lights at football and volleyball games. We considered ourselves the lucky ones, having finally won the spirit stick at pep rallies, dressing out for dress-up days and singing We Are Young at the top of our lungs, commemorating the idea that we were almost done with high school. Suddenly, as we turned the page towards the new year, never in our wildest dreams did we think the next turn of events would occur. However, as we all know too well, as if junior year was not hard enough, we were struck with a pandemic on top of it. What was supposed to be a fun and extra week of spring break turned into the rest of junior year being online and a cruel summer of quarantine to follow, which feels like a blank space in time looking back on it. Finally, last August, we watched the new year begin again. Tis the season, senior year, only different, where everything has changed. Soon it will get better, we thought, as weeks turned into months of online school and mask mandates. But the epiphany eventually struck that this would be how our senior year would go. However, we continued on with the year undergoing activities for the last time. Our last first day of school, our last homecoming week, our last football game, our last pep rally, our last official first day in person, our last ceremonies and banquets, our last and only prom, and finally, our last week of school. So it goes without saying, we have reached the end game, graduation. Despite our trials and tribulations, we have had our triumphs as well. We have been able to shake it off and persist as we have reached the end of our chapter as high school seniors. Call it what you want, but we are survivors. We underwent a hurricane, snow, broken AC systems and power outages, an election, worldwide protests, a freeze, and a pandemic, all in the midst of being in high school and enduring that simultaneously. Forever and always, we will be the one class to have done all of that and persevered despite all odds. Although our parents and our family are out watching right now, wishfully thinking we would never grow up, we are here now, and may we remain the class to long live. Without further ado, class of 2021, as we walk the stage in a moment, let this be a reminder today and every day to follow that we will be remembered as the class of survivors. And there is no doubt we will continue to stride in strength and faith as we close out this phase of our life and embark on this new journey ahead. Thank you.
Would you please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for our Star Spangled Banner.
Forward! March!
You may be seated. Good evening. As the interim principal of Toloso Midway High School, it is my privilege to welcome each and every one of you to the Toloso Midway High School graduation ceremony honoring the class of 2021. Two campuses, Toloso Midway High School and Toloso Midway Academic Career Center, are represented tonight by these outstanding young people. It is at this time we will recognize some very special individuals in our audience. First, parents, guardians, and grandparents. Without your love and support, these students would not be here this evening. Would you please stand and receive a well-deserved, heartfelt thank you? You may be seated. Toloso Midway Independent School District is fortunate to have wonderful educators and staff. Would the TMISD educators and staff please stand so we can thank you for all the help you have given the class of 2021. You may be seated. It is an honor to introduce members of the Tolosa Midway Independent School District Board of Trustees. Please stand as you are introduced. President Paul Mostella. Vice President Felix Landine Jr. Secretary Stephen Holscher. Vice Secretary Jan Mostella. Trustee Ben Benavides. Trustee Kimberly Boone. And Trustee John Samaniego. Representing the district's central administration, Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Rick Fernandez. Assistant Superintendent for District Operations, Patrick Hernandez. Director of Special Education, Ms. Yolanda Alvaro. Director of Technology, Trish Panknin. And Business Manager, Philip Carroll. Representing the Campus Administration, Assistant Principal, Mrs. Stacy Lucas. Assistant Principal, Mr. Joey Mendoza. And Assistant Principal, Ms. Priscilla Vega. The Principal of the Academic Career Center, Mrs. Melody McLaren. And Assistant Principal, Mrs. Iris Chapa. The High School Testing and College and Career Readiness Coordinator, Ms. Rose Perez. The High School Counselors are Ms. Lindsay Bowers, Mrs. Nelda Garibay, Mrs. Annette Hinojosa, and Mrs. Cheryl Marley. And the ACC counselor, Mrs. Frances Bean. At this time, I would like to introduce Tolosa Midway High School's 2021 salutatorian, a student who has performed at an exceptional level in all endeavors during her high school career. Would our salutatorian's family please stand? Let me present Miss Jennifer Zack.
Good evening, fellow graduates, friends, families, teachers, faculty, and alumni. We are gathered here to celebrate the graduation of my peers sitting before me. I'm Jennifer Zack, and just 5 years ago, I was sitting in your seats in the audience watching my sister's graduation, anticipating the time I would finally be graduating and hopefully be up on this stage giving my very own speech. Now, here I am. I have been given the opportunity to speak before my peers to tell the story of our high school careers and inspire everyone for the future. And hopefully it doesn't come out as cliche as you may already seem like it will be. Throughout high school, we have looked forward to this coveted day, and now it's not a distant reality anymore. It's here. We made it. The class of 2021 overcame so many hardships to get to this very ceremony right now. The pandemic tested our limits, affecting us for over a year. No one thought our senior year would be minimized to online school, wearing masks everywhere we went, and fearing for our health and safety. I would like to take this time to acknowledge the people that preserved the most throughout the pandemic, our healthcare workers. Without them, we wouldn't have the care that was necessary to fight against COVID. Can we please give a round of applause to all the healthcare workers, whether in the building or those who we know? No matter how hard the pandemic tested us, we overcame those obstacles to the best of our abilities. I believe if all of the people in this convention center can overcome a year such as this, we can overcome any obstacle that comes our way in the near future. Class of 2021, we are on the road to finding our future endeavors. Whether it be college, work, the military, or still deciding, we are the flame that can ignite change in this world. We see in our society the adversities facing citizens across America. Social injustice plagues our society and is the voice of the new generation that has sparked the change that we have longed hoped to see. We may see division in our society, almost as divisive as my tan lines from golf, but the bonds we build in high school prove we can always come together to build a society through unison. No matter the pressure that comes from the typical norms of society, we have the free will to speak our own truths. Never fear in the face of adversity, because the outcome can create so much change and inspire others to use their voice and achieve their goals. We are at the point of our lives where we feel the most free we have ever felt. Finally graduating high school and becoming adults to go out into the real world is a tremendous feeling of freedom and individuality. Michelle Obama once said, "I have found that this journey has been incredibly freeing, because no matter what happened, I have had the peace of mind knowing that all of the chatter, the name calling, the doubting, all of it was just noise. It did not define me, it didn't change who I was, and most importantly, it couldn't hold me back." Throughout high school, I aimed to be the best version of myself that I could possibly be, someone who I would be proud of. My peers around me shaped the person who I am today. I've attended Toloso Midway ever since kindergarten, and many of us have here too. It was a long 12 years to learn who we would become, and I'll be honest, school was pretty rough for me, and I'm sure it was for a lot of people here. But that's okay. No one is going to ever have a perfect high school experience. But now looking back, there may be some things I wish I could have changed, but I wouldn't change the experience that came out of it. I wouldn't be the person I am today if I didn't learn every step of the way to make it through high school. I always stressed myself to always get the best grades and to never settle for anything less. I remember crying after getting my first B back in fourth grade. Oh, what a naive little girl I was. The person standing before you still stresses about their grades, but has also learned the importance of building relationships and learning to have a little fun. And I hope everyone at this very moment is proud of who they are and proud of getting to this milestone in our lives. We've gone through it all from our freshman year, being typical nervous freshmen who were trying to decide where we would go find our footing, while also trying to survive Hurricane Harvey. To sophomore year, we're getting a little more comfortable and responsibilities start to kick in when we start to learn how to drive. Although it seems like I still haven't mastered that task whatsoever. Junior year, the year that we probably all wish didn't have to happen. We're starting college level classes, we're starting to study for SATs and ACTs, and getting ready to apply for college. What was already one of the most stressful years of high school was then interrupted by COVID-19. We all thought it would be an extra week off from school, but in reality, it would be a full pandemic that forced us to quarantine and turn to remote learning. We all said that the pandemic would be over before our senior year started, but were we greatly mistaken? We continued online school through the first 6 weeks, and then we had the choice of coming back to school or staying online. Heavily tested, trying to juggle school, keeping up our grades while feeling isolated at home. Until April 26th, we finally are all back to school and able to talk to all of our friends face to face. Although we weren't given many of the normal senior activities, we still made the most out of this year. We had a historic year of state qualifications, making it to state in academic and speech events, in debate, in golf, track, swimming, tennis, and much, much more. We had state champions in the UIL one-act play, and we still made it to the football games to cheer our hearts out. We had an unforgettable senior prom.
All these events and many more made us proud to be representing and graduating from Toloso Midway High School. Now we're here sitting in this graduation ceremony, most likely anticipating when this is over to finally feel like we're done. This whole process wouldn't be possible without the help from teachers, staff, and family. So I would like to give a few shout outs to them. First, my parents. Without them, I wouldn't be here today, but they have supported me throughout all of high school, and them being Asian parents made sure my grades never fell short from an A. My sister, who truly has been an inspiration to me and my ultimate role model, so much so that I have been called Kelly more times than I think my actual name. Mrs. Jones, who believed in the voice that I could use to create change and advocate for what I believed in. Coach Pacheco for being the most supportive golf coach that I could ever ask for. Ms. Cardenas for being the breath of fresh air in a stressful school environment. Mrs. Hughes for always bringing happiness to my days and being the best business teacher there is. And my friends who made high school a little more fun and taught me how to talk about my emotions and get through this thing called high school. But everyone at Toloso Midway had a positive impact on me and my success. So thank you TMISD for being the building blocks of my education and my character. But enough about myself. If there's anything that I want you all to take from today, is to leave a legacy and to achieve greatness. While not purely looking for wealth, but crossing paths with those that can create happiness and hope. From the bottom of my heart, I wish everyone a successful and fulfilling future. Thank you.
Toloso Midway High School's 2021 valedictorian is an accomplished scholar who has worked extremely hard to maintain an exemplary academic record throughout her high school career. Would our valedictorian's family please stand? Let me present our valedictorian, Ms. Riley King.
Well, class of 2021, we made it. Today, we are all graduating and becoming a part of the history at Toloso Midway High School, home of the Warriors and Cherokees. If you're like me, I started my educational career at Toloso Midway as a kindergartner. I remember my first day of school at TM. I was excited to get to learn new things, but I was also worried since I did not have one of my best friends since pre-K, Jacob Getzelman, in my kindergarten class. Despite not knowing anybody my first day, it was the kind people like Heavenly Vasquez, Adrian Molina, and the inspiring teachers that made TM a great place to learn. I can even remember waiting in the gym for my mom to pick me up, filled with excitement so that I could ask, can I come back tomorrow? Because I knew that TM was the place I wanted to call my educational home away from home for the next 13 years. Fast forward through primary, intermediate, and middle school, our final 4 years at TM have been ones to remember. The second week of our freshman year, we got a few days off due to air conditioning issues, followed by Hurricane Harvey and a delayed school day due to snow. Our junior year started off with another air conditioning day, canceling our Western-themed pep rally, and ended with the global pandemic. While we all had high hopes of returning to school for July, our senior year began the same and really went by in a Zoom, only to start our last semester of high school with a statewide major freeze. Thankfully, though, we were all able to come back to campus and complete our last few weeks of senior year together with some normalcy. Over the last 4 years, you could say that the class of 2021 has lived through some events that are bound to be written in history books. But not only will the hurricane, freeze, and pandemic live in infamy, we have also gotten to witness a lot of great history being made here at our school. For starters, the video production team consisting of myself, Joanne Robledo, Isabella Rodriguez, Jennifer Zack, and Kane Malachite qualified for national competition through Business Professionals of America. Our one-act play has some members that I guarantee we will be seeing in movies like Lorena San Pedro and Jesse Garibay. Ellie Herrick, Heavenly Vasquez, and Elisha Villegas sure are runners and track stars after qualifying for region and state many times in cross-country and track events. Our poultry judging team is pretty excellent at making history, with Allison Russell, Carly French, and Emily Dreyer qualifying for state. And you may as well call Jennifer Zach the Tiger Woods of TM with all of her success in golf. And this year, our girls' soccer team were area champions for the first time in TM history. And we can't forget about the success of our other teams like band and choir, in addition to volleyball, basketball, and tennis. You see, these are just a few of the many examples of history being made and legacies being left here at TM. But it is not only these students and their academic and athletic ability, but their friendship and kindness that have made going to school here the highlight of my last 13 years of life. Sitting behind the scenes of all of our students' success are the countless hours and work put in by our amazing and inspiring teachers. They're the ones who make it all happen and are the reason for our success. From putting in the long hours with us outside of school, practicing with us, to make sure we have the knowledge and tools we need to be successful both in and out of the classroom. I would like to personally thank Ms. Hughes and Mr. Jackson for being the best BPA coaches and business and technology teachers in the world, and for supporting myself and teammates since middle school through historical wins at the region, state, and national contests in Business Professionals of America. Thank you, Mrs. Waddle, for taking over the UIL science team these past 2 years and coaching us to more historical results here at TM, with the UIL science team being district champions for the first time. Mrs. Waddle, your smile and continuous perseverance was very inspiring this year as the tech gremlins were continuously taking over your Zoom and Google classroom most days. And to Ms. Walker, thank you for being the most dedicated academic decathlon coach by learning all of the decathlon information with us every year, and for keeping me on my toes with your "What did I say yesterday?" quizzes. The list goes on forever with the countless teachers that have all played an important role in not only my life, but of all the other graduates here at TM. I would also like to thank the staff, administrators, school board members, and other faculty members at TM for making our school the best that it can be, and for making events like senior awards, prom, and graduation today possible. Finally, I would like to thank my family members and friends who have all supported me in my goals, no matter how crazy they may be. Mom, thank you for all of your help and support, for proofreading my essays and discussion posts, no matter how late at night it may be. Dad, thank you for always being there for me and for turning down the TV when you got home so that I could quietly study in my room. And to my sister, Sydney, thank you for being the comedic relief I always need after a long day at school. I'm really going to miss driving you to school next year, and I know you'll do great things in your future. Thank you, Elaine and Caitlin, for getting me involved in 4-H and agriculture, because without you, I would not be the person that I am today. And thank you to one of my best friends, Reagan Fox, for being my 4-H and livestock show buddy, and my other best friend, Reagan Helsher, for being a role model that I could look up to and for being my horse crazy friend since the fourth grade. And finally, thank you to Allison Russell for being the best friend that a girl could ask for and for always listening to me stress about schoolwork. And finally, thank you to the person who I call my adopted grandmother, Charlene Fleck, for giving me a ride home from school every day until I got my driver's license. And thank you for all of the memories we made as we tell stories, sew, and bake at your house. And thank you for letting me do my homework at your house during the week of the freeze, because you had electricity and internet that entire week. Class of 2021, now that our time here at TM is finally coming to an end, I hope that you will remember all of the great people, memories, and success that we have had together. We have all made history here at TM and have hopefully inspired the underclassmen and up-and-coming primary, intermediate, and middle school students to do the same. Our time here at TM was short, and now that we have left our legacy at Tolosa Midway, it is time for us to move on to bigger and better things. I challenge all of you to follow your dreams and make your mark on the world, just as we have done here at TM. Congratulations, class of 2021, and I can't wait to see what the future has in store for us.
At this time, we will recognize several very special groups of students in this outstanding graduating class. Will the 2021 cum laude graduates please stand? You may be seated. Will the students graduating with one or more endorsements and a distinguished level of achievement please stand? You may be seated. Will the academic top 10% of the class of 2021 please stand? You may be seated. Will the seniors who have earned between 3 and 32 college hours through our partnership with Del Mar College at this time, will the 19 dual credit students who earned 24 college hours or more and received a Del Mar College Award for this remarkable achievement please stand? You may be seated. Will the 6 graduates who participated at the Del Mar College graduation ceremony for earning 27 college hours towards a level 1 certificate in welding please stand to be recognized for this wonderful achievement? You may be seated. We partnered with the University of Texas in Austin. Will the seniors who earned UT college hours and received a UT cord please stand? You may be seated. Will the students graduating who have earned Eagle Scout rank please stand? Anybody? Will each student who has attended Toloso Midway Independent School District from kindergarten through the present please stand? You may be seated. Now, seniors, please stand. Dr. Fernandez, by the authority vested in me by the Texas Education Agency and the Toloso Midway Board of Trustees, I certify that the candidates standing before you have fulfilled all the requirements for graduation as set forth by the State of Texas and the Toloso Midway Independent School District. I, therefore, recommend to you that these candidates be certified as graduates of Toloso Midway High School Class of 2021.
Well, good evening, graduates. Parents, they're a little closer to getting off the payroll. We got a couple of more steps. Some of you know that they're not off the payroll for well beyond high school, like myself. So it's my honor to be here tonight, and without further ado, let's get started. Dr. White, as superintendent of schools and by the authority vested in me by the Texas Education Agency and the Toloso Midway Board of Trustees, I accept your recommendation to certify these candidates for graduation. Mr. Paul Mostella, I hereby certify these seniors for graduation. I recommend to you that these candidates be granted diplomas as the graduating class of 2021 from Toloso Midway High School. Seniors, you may be seated.
Carla Aceves. Brenna Aguirre. Heriberto Alanis Sanchez. Isaiah Alanis. Emily Allen. Joshua Alvarado. Aiden Andrade. Bailey Arevalo. Amaris Amada. Brianna Valderamos. Ethan Baldonado. Pedro Baldonado. Jenna Barrera. Tyler Battersby. Amalia Begay. Diana Belford. Valdemar Benavides III. Christian Benavides. Lillian Bernal. Giovanni Bersosa Salto. Soham Bhakta. Weston Book. Hunter Boone. Charity Brown. Alyssa Buentello. Sierra Buentello. Kaylee Cabrera. Arturo Cáceres Jr. Emily Cáceres. Jesse Calderon III. Ian Cameron. Natalia Canelo. Isaiah Cantu. James Cantu. Miranda Cantu. Alexandra Caro. Avery Carpenter. Aubrey Carrera. Jody Cáceres. Matthew Cáceres. Allison Castillo. Matthew Cavazos Gonzalez. Toby Chadwick. Brianna Chapa. Jacob Chavetta. Chris Shavir. Victor Coleman. Austin Contreras. Donovan Cooper. Kyla Cooper. Valeria Covarrubias Garay. Kevin Crimmins. Ethan Cuellar. Braylon De Los Santos. Elila De Leon. Aaliyah Delgado. Jocelyn Diaz. Skylyn Edwards. Brianna Etter. Christopher Falcon. Morgan Ferguson. Gabriela Fernandez. Christopher Fernandez Zamorano. Brianna Flores. Destiny Flores. Gabriela Flores. Jacob Flores. Julian Flores. Serena Flores. Bryce Frankie. Carly French. Jorge Fuentes. Marcos Fuentes Polanco. Raul Garza. Rosa Gallardo. True Gamboa. Adrian Gomez. Eliseo Garcia. Julia Garcia. Nathan Garcia. Pilar Garcia. Xiomara Garcia.
Jesse Garibay. Cecilia Garcia. Faith Garza. George Garza. Maricela Garza. Natalie Garza. Samuel Gatlin. Andrea George. Jacob Getzelman. Tyler Gilpin. Christopher Gomez. Angelo Gonzalez. Darren Gonzalez. Gavin Gonzalez. Jocelyn Gonzalez. Shariel Gonzalez Collazo. Julian Gracia. James Graves Jr.
Aaron Griffin. Justin Guerra. Caitlin Guerra. Julian Guerrero. Noah Guzman. Kobe Hernandez. Jesus Hernandez. Leslie Hernandez. Nicholas Hernandez. Victoria Hernandez. Myra Hernandez Salinas. Elizabeth Herrick. Adalisa Hinojosa. Chloe Hinojosa. Evan Hood. Madison Ibanez. Jackson Iglesias. Emily Igo. Layla Jackson. Nicholas Hawkes. Gabriela Jimenez. Emily Johnson. Lana Johnson. Naya Jones. Francisco Kelly Benavides. Michael Ketchum. Yeah. Riley King. Reagan Krish. Lennon Lambert. Courtney Lamontang. Christina Lara. Christian Laureano. Oscar Laureano. Jose Lerma Jr. Mia Lewis. Micah Lissenby. Juan Lopez. Ricardo Lopez III. Sophia Lopez. Isabella Laredo. Joshua Luera. Wesley Lug. Andrea Lugo. Jason Luke. Michaela Luna. Michael Luna. Kane Malachite. Kyler Marquez. Jaron Marshall. Caleb Martinez. Isaac Martinez. Raylin Martinez. Guinevere April Matthew. Ryan McCauley. Ryan McGrew. Adam McKenna. Alasia Miave. Haley Mills. Adrian Molina. And Lydia Montes. Zachary Moore. Isabella Moreau. Juan Moreno the Fourth. Caitlin Muiz. Denise Navarro. Bernice Navarro Melendez. Jesus Nino. Justin Nitzel. Muno Chismo Wampa. Abigail Oliver. Annalise Oliver. Aubrey Ortner.
Cameron Baez. Sebastian Baez. Cesar Palacios Rocha. Kyle Palmatier. Daniel Pedrosa. Tyreek Pete. Draven Pena. Harley Pena. Isaac Papard. Raul Perez. Sarah Perez. Julia Peterson. Aaron Pisana. Lorenzo Ponce. Alexis Ramirez. Denise Ramirez. Destiny Ramirez. Jacob Ramirez. Raymond Ramirez. Aaron Rashad Jr. Molly Jo Reed. Isabella Reyes. Gunner Rich. Miranda Riojas. Alina Rios. Jaime Rios Jr. Julissa Rios. Devin Rivera. Marco Antonio Rivera. Joanne Robledo. Jada Rodarte. Angel. Angel Rodriguez. Eileen Rodriguez. Gilbert Rodriguez Jr. Haley Rodriguez. Isabella Rodriguez. Got it. Mindy Garcia Rodriguez. Liliana Rodriguez. Liliana Rodriguez Zuniga. Enrique Romero. Nicholas Rosales. Ray Rosas. Montana Rowe. Jessica Rubel. Destiny Ruiz. Jasmine Ruiz. Allison Russell. Odalis Rubalcava Esparza. Ashley Sade Martinez. Trinidad Salazar Jr. Haley Salinas. Jersey Salinas. Sarah Salinas. Lorena San Pedro. Mario Sanchez. Timoteo Sanchez. Zachary Sanders. Juan Angel Sandoval. Natalia Salceda. Raymond Salceda. Kimberly Schulte. I got it. Kimberly Keely Cyril. Michael Serna Jr. Diana Silva. Morgan Simpson. Haley Scarupa. Sean Scarupa. Joseph Smith. Emily Solis. Leonel Solis the third. Roel Soto Jr. Cody Stace. You'll be great. Delissa Dogler. Haley Talavera. Braulio Rafael Torres. Aaron Trevino. You got this. Aaron Trevino. Kai Trevino. Mary Jane Trevino. Lance Turner. Miguel Valadez. Natalie Valdez. Hunter Van Manen. Aiden Vargas. Donovan Vasquez. Yes. Elissa Vasquez. Heavenly Vasquez. Ray Vasquez. John Vega Rosas. Nelissa Verdín. Elijah Villegas. Jaden Whitehead. Christian Wilkie. Martin Williams. Mackenzie Woodard. Jennifer Zapp. Richard Yanez Jr. Lillian Ibarra. Ileana Zamorano. Rolando Zaragoza. Jesus Zuniga Espinosa.
Thank you. seniors, the class of 2021, you've had an interesting year. A lot of adversities and a lot of things you had to adjust to and adapt to. You met that challenge and you did it well. And here you are today, graduating as a class of Tolosa Midway High School 2021. Will you please stand? Always remember, if you have a dream, follow it. It will come true because you've met the challenge, and in this next phase of your life, make that dream come true. At this time, change your tassels from the left to the right side of your mortarboards. Dr. Fernandez, on behalf of Tolosa Midway Independent School District, I accept your recommendation for the granting of diplomas and thereby declare these seniors as the 2021 graduating class of Tolosa Midway High School. Please join us in singing the alma mater.
Seniors, please have a seat for our closing by Miss Joanne Robledo.
Good evening. We have finally made it to the end. Hi, my name is Joanne Robledo, and I'm honored to be giving the farewell speech on behalf of the class of 2021. I want to thank my mom and Mrs. Ramirez Garza for encouraging me to write this speech and include anything more than just some brief goodbye to y'all. Since I was a young child, my mom has taught me, si eres feliz haciendo algo que te apasiona, nadie puede decirte que no tienes éxito. If you are happy doing something that makes you passionate, no one can tell you otherwise and tell you you're not successful. I have come from a family history of dropouts and empty advice, but now I'm proud to say I will be a first-generation college student at the University of Texas at Austin with a full-ride scholarship as their first accepted student to the School of Nursing. However, this milestone is not just my victory, but it is all of ours. The 9 kids I stand with on the top 10 banner have pushed me to excel in the classroom. The senior class that sits in front of me has impressed me and motivated me with their own achievements and records in their own crafts. The staff and faculty that have raised us for the past 4 years have been there to cheer us on our victories and be a shoulder to cry on during our defeats. My friends, including my best friends Isabel and Kane, have been with me throughout the AP classes, clubs, and band for at least the past 7 years. Finally, my parents, Laura and Jose Robledo, thank you for everything and for your unconditional support. And yes, you too, Joel Robledo. So let us depart now, and never let us forget the legacy we imprinted on TMISD as the resilient class of 2021. Thank you.
Family and friends, after the recessional, you are welcome to meet your graduates outside by the east side of the building on Shoreline. Thank you all so much.